Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this session, we'll be learning about event propagation. jQuery provides several event methods. First one is prevent default. Prevent default method is used to prevent browser's default action. Second is default prevented. Is default prevented method can be used to check if the prevent default method was fired or not. Stop propagation. Stop propagation method is used to prevent event from bubbling to its parents. Is propagation stopped checks whether stop propagation was fired or not. Similarly, stop immediate propagation is used to cancel all other event handler methods. Is immediate propagation stopped checks if stop immediate propagation was fired or not. Let's see all this in practical.
Here in our web page, we have a H1 tag which says event propagation. We have an anchor tag with a link to tutorialspoint.com which says click me. We have a paragraph tag which says click me to see, and inside a paragraph tag, we have a span tag which says stop propagation. We have included jQuery from code.jquery.com CDN. In our script tag, we have written $a.click function. So we are giving this anchor tag a click event. And inside function, we have written e.preventDefault. This e.preventDefault will prevent the default browser's action. So we should see nothing happen when we click on this link. Let's see the output. When I click on click me, nothing should happen. It should not redirect us to tutorialspoint.com. So when I click, we see nothing happens, and in our log, we can see is default prevented is returned true. That's because here I have written console.log is default prevented, and I have called the method e.isDefaultPrevented here, which checks if e.preventDefault method was fired or not. Next is, we have used $span.click, and inside handler function, I have written alert stop propagation. So whenever I click on span, I should get an alert box which says stop propagation. And since the span resides inside paragraph tag, so whenever I click on span, the event on paragraph should also be fired, which says hi. I should get two alert boxes, first one saying stop propagation and second one saying hi. Let's see the output. When I click on stop propagation, we can see the first alert box which says stop propagation, and second alert box which says hi. So both the events were fired, and is propagation stopped is returned to false, which I have written here in console.log. I have called e.isPropagationStop method, which checks if e.stopPropagation was fired or not. Now let's uncomment this and check. Now I'm using e.stopPropagation method here, so we should see only one alert box, that is the span one. When I click on stop propagation, we can see first alert box which says stop propagation, and in our console log, we can see is propagation stopped returned true. So that's how e.stopPropagation method works. Next thing is, I have given $h1.click event, and the function we have written alert immediately stop propagation. So whenever I click on h1, it should immediately stop propagation. Here I've given another click function which says alert after immediately stopping propagation. So by default, I should see two alert boxes when I click on H1. Let's see the output. When I click on H1, I see first alert box which says immediately stop propagation, and the second which says after immediately stopping propagation. So both these events were fired. Now, when I uncomment e.stopImmediatePropagation, let's see the output. The first alert box which says immediately stop propagation, that's it. We do not see the second alert box. And in our console, we can see is immediate stop propagation stopped returned to true. That's how stopped immediate propagation works. And also in our console.log, we have written e.isImmediatePropagationStopped, which checks if e.stopImmediatePropagation was fired or not. That's all about event propagation methods. Thank you.